for me, for my sister-in-law, and was carrying my son's bloody shoes. When I went out, because I actually was just right up the street from where it happened, when I went out, they had already blocked off the area, and I was trying to get the deputy's attention to see what had happened to my son. And it took about 15 minutes or so, and finally one of the officers came and asked me what I wanted, and I said, what happened to my son? And as my son, I heard something happened to him. And they, oh, well, there was, you know, the incident with the dog, and he was accidentally struck by a bullet. And he said, but he's okay, he'll be fine. And I asked, well, what hospital he's going to be at? And they sent me to Ponder Regional. I then went home, grabbed my sister-in-law, and went to Ponder Regional, where they did not have my son. I started driving to Lancaster to AB. Meanwhile, I had my sister-in-law call over there to see if they had him, but they did not have him. So I had to return to the scene of the crime, get the attention of the officers again, where they left me on the street for 15 minutes and then finally came back and said, oh, he's at AB. So we go there, and apparently two police officials were denying access to my son. They wanted to let me know if he was okay. That's all I wanted to know, if he was alive. But the officer told me he was going to be okay, so we're there from 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning up till 12 or 1 o'clock in the afternoon with no answers. As we're sitting there, you know, making all these phone calls to the higher people to see, you know, if someone can at least come out and talk to him. Even the doctor said that they had no access to my son.
Wow.
There was two police officers guarding the room, and that there was a person inside with them. So I'm like, well, okay, well, did we at least have somebody looking after him? And they gave me a blank look, and oh yeah, someone was looking after him. So the doctor finally comes out about, he was after the staff that was already there changed, you know, to another staff. Yeah, they changed shift. They sent out the new people to talk to me. Whoever the doctor or whoever it was, he came out and he introduced himself. Yeah, the charge nurse, and he said something, and we're like, okay, well, where is he? But under his breath, he said, I'm sorry, I lost. But he was looking around, and we're like, what? Excuse me? And he goes, oh, I'm sorry, I thought you were somebody else. So it didn't register at the time. I found out my son was dead through a friend who was watching that Antelope Valley News as I was sitting there in the hospital waiting for an explanation. So not only did they keep me from saying my last possible goodbye in any kind of way, they still didn't give me answers. They still didn't let me go up in the back, and they still didn't let me identify my son's body when it was time to. They still didn't even notify me that my son was dead, even after I told them I already knew. The only way